busy kitchen. We're all making mayonnaise today on the French Chef.
French Chef is made possible by a grant from Hills Brothers Coffee Incorporated and by a grant from the Polaroid Corporation.
Welcome to the French Chef. I'm Julia Child. You know, I just don't think there's anything that's any better than homemade mayonnaise. It's just so, I don't know, thick and eggy and lovely, and it just, tastes so good. Only trouble with it is, once you start making your own, you'll never be happy with anything else. Because, I don't know, there's something about that homemade flavor, because you can make it any way you want. And it's just so delicious, and it's terribly easy to make. All you have to know is, you have to know about understanding the egg yolk. Because all mayonnaise is just egg yolks and oil beaten together to make a thick sauce, like mayonnaise. And you can make it in all kinds of ways. You can make it in the blender, or you can make it in the mixer, or you can use this funny machine that has a cover with a funnel and a handle, and then underneath is a paddle. And it's a little bit slow, but it makes mayonnaise very well. Or you can make it very easily by hand. And the first way we're going to do is making mayonnaise by hand, because as the whole problem is with the egg yolk, making it by hand, you can really spy on the egg yolk, that dreadful monster which so many people find very difficult. And we're going to make 2.5 cups of mayonnaise, and we want to have 3 egg yolks. And one thing, if you have a lot of egg yolks left over, there's nothing better than to make mayonnaise. Suppose you've made a lot of meringue desserts and vacherins, and you had all these egg yolks left over so that you could make mayonnaise with it. And if you've never made mayonnaise by hand before, don't use less than 3 egg yolks, because if you use, say, 1 or 2 egg yolks, you'll find that the mayonnaise is a little hard to take. And if you use 3, 4, 5, 6, or 7, you can make it very quickly because there is enough volume in it. And if one problem is sometimes if you try making mayonnaise in the wintertime and your kitchen is cold, you find it's very difficult to make. So your first precaution is to warm your mixing bowl. That just means put it in warm water and rinse it out and just have it just so it's about as warm as your hand. And then when you put your egg yolks in, even if you have, if your egg yolks are cold, that will warm them up a little bit, because egg yolks can be a little balky. I think that's the trouble, that they're balky, but if you treat them nicely and sternly, you're going to be able to make them do just what you want. And the first thing you do is, after you've had your warm bowl, you take a big whip and you start beating them up. And you notice I've got my bowl on a wet pot holder. That just holds it nicely. And this is the first point in making mayonnaise by any method, is that you beat your egg yolks first until they're sort of get thick and sticky and rather pale yellow. This is the whole business, and if you just master them and beat them up, and they're going to act the way you want them to. And if you're doing it in an electric mixer, you do just exactly the same thing. And get a nice big mixer, a big beater, and this is just about a minute of beating, and you see they've just thickened slightly, and they're going to thicken a little bit more when I put the flavoring in. But always be sure to take this precaution. And then we have our preliminary flavoring. We have 1/2 teaspoon of salt. And then we have about 1/4 teaspoon of dry mustard. And both the salt and the dry mustard help the eggs to coagulate a little bit. And then you beat in just a drop or two of either wine vinegar or of lemon juice or a bit of both. And I'm going to put in I like a combination of both, so I'll beat in both a few drops of lemon juice and a few drops of vinegar. And don't beat in too much at first. This is just to lighten the mixture. And then beat it up again. I don't know why it is, but this dry mustard helps everything to coagulate. And once that the egg yolks have been beaten, then they are ready to receive the oil. You see, it looks almost like a mayonnaise now. And then at this point, you are ready to start beating in your oil. But you have to decide what flavor you want for your mayonnaise. I always thought mayonnaise was made only with olive oil, but when I got to Paris, I found that they used huile d'arachide, which is a tasteless cooking oil. And that was because if you have too fruity an olive oil, say, and you're eating it with cold lobster or a delicate cold fish, you'll find that your mayonnaise has masked the whole flavor of the fish. And so you want to decide what you're going to serve the mayonnaise on so that it will be a perfect blending. Down in Marseille, where I used to live, they always used a very strong, fruity olive oil, and they beat a lot of garlic into it, and you couldn't taste anything but the garlic mayonnaise. And what I usually do is use part tasteless cooking oil and then part a very nice light French olive oil. But the whole point of making your own is that you can make your own flavor and you can use the really good oil that you would like to use with it. And you have your second point. The first one was beating the egg yolks first, and then the second point is adding the oil. Because the oil has to be added just by little droplets at first, because egg yolks have a very delicate digestion. And if you dump a lot of oil in, the egg yolk just refuses to digest and the sauce refuses to thicken. And you can add the oil either by little teaspoonfuls or you can add it directly by the bottle. And you have to keep beating all the time that you add the oil. And this brings us up to the kind of whips you should use. Now, there are several sizes, and you should use the size of whip that's going to fit your bowl. Now, this is a little baby whip. It's a very cute thing, but it's only good for little baby things. It wouldn't be good in a big bowl. And this is a medium whip, which is about 9 inches long and about 2 inches across. And this is good for doing things such as mixing canned soup in a small saucepan. And then you have your great big balloon whip. And this is 16 inches long, and it's 4.5 to 5 inches across here. And this is wonderful if you're going to make a gallon of mayonnaise in a big bowl. I usually use this for beating up egg whites, and it's marvelous. And these are all French whips, and they're made out of wires which have a tin wash on them. You can get other whips that are made out of stainless steel, and most every store nowadays carries wire whips, and if you have any trouble, go to a restaurant or kitchen supply store, and they have all kinds. Now, in this bowl here, which is sort of a mediumly large bowl, I have what I call a large whip, which is 12 inches long and about 2.5 inches here across. So now, after the whip talk is done, we'll start adding the oil. And now your egg yolks are thick, and you start adding your oil very, very slowly at first, just in little droplets, just a little tiny drop like that. Or you could add it just by little quarter teaspoon bits. And the trick in this is that you should keep your eye on the oil as you add it so that your hand won't slip. You don't have to look at what you're beating because you can't beat out of the bowl. So remember that. Keep your eye on the bottle and then be beating. And at this first point, you have to add about 1/2 cup of oil before the egg yolks, before the sauce thickens. And this is your most delicate point. And you can't stop beating until your sauce is really thickened. So if your phone rings, you just have to pick up your mayonnaise and just beat it and take it to the telephone, or just don't answer it. And this doesn't take very long. See, that's beginning to thicken up. But even if you think it's gotten fairly thick, keep on just adding it a little bit at a time, and then you'll never have any trouble. And as soon as it has thickened up, you can then add the oil in faster. And this is the same method if you're making mayonnaise in the electric mixer. You would do exactly the same thing. You would add the oil just a little tiny bit at a time first until it had thickened. And it makes no difference what direction you beat in. You can beat around in the other direction. And you don't have to beat fast, fast, fast like that. It's just about 2 strokes per minute, per second. And notice the way I'm beating. I'm beating from my shoulder. And I'm not beating from my shoulder, I'm really beating from my elbow. And if you use that method, you can beat for a very long time. Now, look at the consistency. That's nice and thick now, and you can say that the mayonnaise has taken. And the crisis is now over. You can stop and answer the telephone or go and get a drink of water. And at this point, you can then add the oil by dollops, about like a tablespoon, and just beat it all in, and then add another dollop and keep on adding it. And now you come to your third point, which in the egg yolk's digestive processes, not only does it have a delicate digestion that it won't take a great deal of oil at first, but it also will only take a certain amount of oil. If you add more oil than the little yolk can stomach, then it just gets tired out and the emulsion breaks down and your sauce thins out. And your proportions of oil, the maximum proportion of oil you can add per egg yolk, is 3/4 cup. And to be on the safe side, add 1/2 cup. And we're making mayonnaise with 3 yolks so that we can add 1 1/2 to 2 1/4 cup of oil. And if you wanted to make 1/4 sauce, you'd use 5 yolks and you'd use 6 for safety. Actually, I like quite a lot of egg yolks in the sauce because it gives a nice thick yolky taste. And now when it gets too thick, as it is very thick now, just put in a few drops of vinegar and that thins it out, and then you go on adding your oil. You see, after each big dollop, you just beat it so that the oil has absorbed again. You see, I'm doing this slower than necessary because I'm talking so much. But actually, you can whip up 1/4 of mayonnaise in less than 10 minutes. And you have, the nice thing about doing it yourself, you have perfect control over the flavor and the kind of oil you use. And you don't have to add the full amount of oil. It just depends on whether you want a sort of nice taste or whether you want a little more oily taste. And then after you've added as much oil as you want, but not going over your 3/4 cup per yolk, you then taste it and see what else it needs. That's the nice thing. You can always keep tasting your own mayonnaise. Careful you don't drink it, eat it all up. And then at this point, you probably want a little pepper in. And if you have, use white pepper so that you won't have black specks in it. And if you have fresh herbs such as tarragon or chives, you could then put them in. And some people think that adding a spoonful of boiling water keeps the sauce from turning. You can put a spoonful of boiling water in if you want. I don't personally think it makes any difference at all. One of the nice herbs is tarragon, but that just depends on what you're going to serve the mayonnaise with. And then after you have made your mayonnaise, if you're not going to serve it right away, you want to be sure and put it in some kind of a container and cover it. Doesn't that look lovely and thick? It tastes so good. But an awful lot depends on choosing a good oil. Then you have to be awfully careful with anything that has uncooked egg yolks in it, because raw egg yolks at room temperature are great breeding grounds for bacteria. So I think don't keep it out much more than a few minutes. Cover it and put it into the refrigerator. And one thing, though, when you find in the refrigerator, I found that it won't really keep. I don't dare keep it more than a week just because of spoilage talk. But sometimes you find that if you have left it in the refrigerator, 4 or 5 days, you take it out and stir it up, it thins out. And that's because the egg yolk is cold and its emulsion processes have broken down. And that brings us to the agony of turned mayonnaise. And the reasons it turns are, one, the mayonnaise is too cold, or two, you haven't beaten the eggs before you added the oil. Three, you added the oil too fast at first so that the sauce never thickened up. Or four, you went over your proportions of egg yolks. I mean, of oil per egg yolk. But for whatever reason it turned, it's very easy to fix. And I'll show you how. Now here is a turned sauce. It's just ghastly looking. And you beat it up, and it just doesn't look like anything. But it's very easily fixed, and what you need is some wet mustard. And use the Dijon type, the strong Dijon mustard, and put in about a teaspoon of the mustard. And then take your wire whip, here I'll take this wire whip, and add a spoonful of this ghastly sauce, just about a half spoonful, and beat it until it begins to cream, and then add the sauce just by little droplets until this thickens up. And the wonderful thing about this is that it always works. And that's one reason I think if you're going to make mayonnaise and you're not doing it for any specific purpose, you just want to have some on hand, I wouldn't flavor it up too much at first, because you may find, say, if you've kept it in the refrigerator, that it had turned and you're going to have to use the mustard. But that's the system you use. You just beat it in very slowly until it is all turned into a cream like that, and it absolutely always works. In fact, it's rather fun, I think, because it's such fun to bring it back again. And now we're going to do mayonnaise in the blender. And for the blender, you have to use a whole egg, because if you use just egg yolks, you would find that the machine would clog. So put a whole egg in, and then start the blender high, and then you're going to have the same flavoring in of vinegar or lemon juice, mustard, and salt. And you want to let this beat for about a minute first. And then if you have a blender that has a little top like this, it's very useful, because that keeps it from splattering. So again, we want a quarter teaspoon of salt. It was a half teaspoon of salt and a quarter teaspoon of mustard and a tablespoon of lemon juice or wine vinegar. And then let that beat again for a moment. And then you add your oil. And if you don't have a splatter top, you'll have to hold a towel around it, or else you'll get it all over yourself. And then again, the oil goes in by little driblets. That's the most important part, and just pour it right into the center. You find that by the time you've added a cup of oil, the sauce is very thick. You're really controlled by about how much oil you add, because after you've gotten the oil in them, and you look down inside the machine, the sauce isn't turning at all. It's gotten so thick. And so you can't add any more oil. You could put in a little bit of water and thin it out and add a little bit more oil. But this makes just about a cup of, or a little over a cup of sauce. And this is the way it looks. See, it's lovely and thick and creamy. This is a much lighter mayonnaise than the handmade sauce, just because you're using a whole egg. And if you want a very light sauce, this is a very nice one, but the only trouble is you can only make one cup at a time. Then you dump it out and just start all over again. And the nice thing about the blender sauce that it's really pretty foolproof. Just a six-year-old child could make it perfectly well. And so I think it's an extremely useful method to have, because sometimes you just want to do something very quickly and there it is. But so now you have, once you have your mayonnaise made, as this is just all perfectly plain mayonnaise, you can do all kinds of things with it. For instance, you could, if you wanted to lighten it and have a little more volume, you could fold in some beaten egg whites, or you could stir in some sour cream, or you could beat in some fresh chopped herbs, and that would be called mayonnaise au fines herbes. Or you could stir in some gelatin that had been dissolved in warm water, and then just stir that in and use it for decorating cold fish or chicken, and that's called mayonnaise collée. Or you can make a green mayonnaise, which is rather fun, and that's called a mayonnaise verte. And all you do for that is just to stir a lot of cooked greenery into the mayonnaise. And you can use any kind of greenery you want. Just sort of roughly chop it and put it in some boiling water just to soften it. It depends on what you use. You want it just to be cooked enough to soften it. And if you haven't got much else around, you usually always have some scallions, and you can use the part of that and then up into the green, which gives you a green color and flavoring. You can use spinach, which is very good. Watercress is lovely. But with your herbs, which are much more delicate, you'd wait until, 4 or 5 minutes until this had softened, and then you'd put your herbs in and let them boil for just about a minute or two. So in other words, you can do, with your greenery, you can make just about what you would like in the way of green, because you want flavor as well as color. And so you want to let this come up to the boil, and just, it's what this is, blanching or wilting. And then, as soon as that is cooked and wilted, you want to drain it out. And you just drain that out in the sink. And then if you have an electric blender, you just put it right into the blender. At first though, after draining it, it's a good idea to rinse it in cold water, because the rinsing in cold water seems to set the greenery. And then that just goes right into the blender. And there should be enough water in it so it'll mash down all right. I could have done it with that. There. Now, I don't like these things pureed too fine, because I don't like it to look like baby food. And once when I went to a restaurant, I had what they called a green mayonnaise, and all they'd done was put green coloring in it. And that's not what you want, because you want the flavor. And you can always tell if it's green coloring, because that has sort of a fake look. And it also doesn't have any consistency to it. Now, be sure, after you've pureed it, that you press all the water out. I think I'll press this out in a bowl so you can see what it looks like. Because if you don't sieve it, you find that there's too much liquid in it, and you find that when you try to make a mayonnaise, that the mayonnaise won't take, because you've got too much water in your herbs. So just remember to drain it out. And then you have all of this beautiful green liquid that you can use for, say, flavoring a soup or something else. And then you can just beat this into your ready mayonnaise. And in this case, I've got the mayonnaise in the mixer. and just add it in gradually. And if you wanted to make the mayonnaise in the blender, after you had sieved this out, you would then just put your green stuff back in, and then put in your whole egg, and put in your salt and mustard, and beat it up for a little while, and pour in your oil, and there you are. So you can do it either way. You see, this is just a lovely color here. But you have to be, I hope this isn't too liquid now. So you want to, when you're going to add your greenery, be sure that you have a fairly thick mayonnaise. But that's a nice color just the way it is. And one thing about the cooked herbs is over the just plain herbs that you chop and put in, is that the herbs have been blanched so that the mayonnaise will keep a little longer. Sometimes if you put just chopped green herbs and put them in the mayonnaise and then keep the mayonnaise for a while, the herbs will turn slightly sour in it, so that if you have the mayonnaise like this, it will keep much better. And then put it in a nice serving bowl and you're all ready to serve it. And there's so many terribly nice things that you can do with this green mayonnaise or just with plain mayonnaise. And I want you to see in the dining room how everything looks. Now, green mayonnaise, I think, is just delicious with cold fish or with cold shrimps, or supposing you have cold boiled lobster, you can just put a lovely dollop of green mayonnaise in that. Or suppose you were doing a little French hors d'oeuvre, just with hard-boiled eggs and a little decorations, you could put the mayonnaise in that. And then with your plain mayonnaise, you can serve that with artichokes, or you can serve that with chicken, have a tomato and put the mayonnaise in. And there's your chicken. Now, I just can't believe you're going to have any trouble making mayonnaise now, because you've really seen everything about it, and I've just gone over all the details. I just don't think you'll find any tricks. And it's a marvelous sauce to have on hand. Just look at all the things you can serve it on. And if you haven't anything to put it on, you can just eat it plain by great big spoonfuls. So that's all for today on The French Chef. This is Julia Child. Bon appétit.
The French Chef has been made possible by a grant from the Polaroid Corporation and by a grant from Hills Brothers Coffee Incorporated. Julia Child is co-author of the book Mastering the Art of French Cooking.